Hello everyone, this is a three-part series and this is part one of the series how to set up and integrate RTI with ECCRS4 along with IBP to enable order-based planning on flexible master data and flexible planning area. The topic of integrating RTI to integrate an on-premise system to a IBP-based cloud system is bit detailed and to some extent complicated in nature, and hence I am going to split this entire session into three parts, wherein in this part or the part one we will focus on setting up the connectivity of IBP and the BTP environment, and how do we do an initial setup in BTP, how we integrate IBP and BTP through specified communication arrangement like 0574 and 0805, and what are the prerequisites for that. That is what we are going to cover today. Now, as a first step of the RTI integration, we should start with BTP, wherein we need to create a subaccount first. Now here, if I go, you will see I am in the BTP cockpit, wherein I have already created a subaccount, and the name of the subaccount is RTI COMPOC. Now as of now, I haven't done any configuration in this subaccount, but as a part of this first part of the demo, that is what I am going to show you, what are the setup that we need to do to set up and integrate first the connectivity between IBP and the BTP. So IBP, the planning area or the order based planning area that we will want to integrate, will basically integrate to a particular sub account in BTP, which in our case is this. Now, from a sub account perspective, there are a few things that is needed which are used as input into different system. One is the subdomain and the other is the sub account ID. Before we proceed further, when a sub account has been created, first and foremost is we need to check whether we have the required entitlements available in the sub account or not. And when I mean by entitlement, what I mean is we need to ensure that if a particular service type is activated in the sub account. So for that, first, as a first step, we should always go to entitlement. And in entitlement, you will see we have multiple services with different service plan type. In order to ensure the connectivity of IBP to BTP, we need to ensure that we have the service called connectivity and the plan type connectivity proxy enabled in the sub account. Without this, the integration cannot be completed and we won't be able to connect IBP to BTP or even ECC S4HANA via the cloud connector to IBP. So first you need to ensure that whether this service and this plan type is enabled. If it is not, then you need to get in touch with the global account administrator and make sure that you enable these services before you proceed. Once done, then you can come back to the sub account, from where we should go to directly to instances and subscription. So once we go to instances and subscription, we see we have three options: subscription, instance, and environments. As a first step, what we will do is we will create an instance. and the instance that we will create is of connectivity service. The plan type should be connectivity proxy. Runtime is other. And in the instance, we can give it any friendly name. Let's say I'm giving RTI underscore POC. Then we create next, next, and we create. Once that is done, the instance RTI POC has been created. Now we need to go inside this instance. Inside this instance, we need to create a service binding. In many cases, you might have seen that Cloud Foundry is mandatory to set up RTI for BTP, but that is not the case anymore. Although Cloud Foundry is required, that I will show in later steps, but at this point of time, we don't need that. Now, if we create a connectivity service without Cloud Foundry, then we need to create service binding. But if we create connectivity service on Cloud Foundry, then the same thing is known as service key. But here, that is not mandatory, hence we are using service binding, where I will go and create a service binding. So let's say I will give it a name, the same name, RTI underscore POC, and I will create. So once it is created here, I can go to view, and from here I will get the JSON which I need in order to create the communication arrangement in IBP. So all I need to do is to select Control A and select all and Control C and go to IBP. In IBP, I will be going into communication arrangement. Then I will create new. In the scenario, let's say I will first select 0805. So by default, the SAP BTP connectivity service for service channel integration is selected. And here, what we have copied from this JSON needs to be pasted here. And we need to create. So once we update the service binding, this communication not only create this communication, along with that, it also creates a communication system, which we can see that it has created here, where it has updated the host name, which is the host name from the BTP account, the port, and so on and so forth. And here, if you see, automatically based on the JSON, the value of the subaccount ID is also updated. Now here we have created SAP COM 0805. Now we'll create the next one, which is 0574. So this is BTP connectivity service for on-premise integration. Here also we create and we update the same service binding that we have got, and we create this. So once we have created this, now you can see 0574 has also been created, and along with that a Z communication system is also generated with a sub account ID and O user authentication client ID and the username which is derived from the service binding. And inside the communication display also, you can primarily see the host name, port number, etc., etc. So this basically ensures that my IBP is now connected to the BTP environment. And just for the purpose of leveling and for understanding, I will just add a friendly level here, the same one, and value is optional, so I will save it here. So at this point of time, what we have done is we have created an instance, we have created a service binding, used the JSON of the service binding, and based on that service binding, we have created communication arrangement 0574 and 0805 that are the BTP related connectivity service. Once that is done, we can come back to the sub account, and here we can enable Cloud Foundry. So Cloud Foundry instance name, these are all auto populated. So I will just give it a user friendly name. And then I will create. So this creation takes some time. So once that is done, once the Cloud Foundry is enabled, you can see we also get an option to create space. So here we will create a space wherein we will select this option of space developer manager auditor. Supporter is not needed. And we will create a space with the name RTI POC. So here inside that space also, you can come and if you go to instances and subscription, now you will see you are having two instances and subscription. One is for the service binding, another is for the Cloud Foundry. So earlier, it was mandatory that we need to have a Cloud Foundry, and inside that Cloud Foundry, we need to create a space under which we need to create the instance. But now IBP connects to BTP without Cloud Foundry. So directly creating an instance and connecting is also okay. The reason why we have created the Cloud Foundry runtime is to ensure that in the next session, when we configure the cloud connector, and when the cloud connector is basically mapped to a particular sub-account, that sub-account needs to have Cloud Foundry enabled in order to ensure that the cloud connector is connected to the BTP system. So that's it for the first session, where we have ensured the required configuration that we need to perform in a BTP sub-account, what input we need from the BTP based on which we can create the BTP related communication arrangement 0805 and 0574 in IBP. In the next session or in the next part of the session, we will cover the cloud connector setup and how to integrate the cloud connector with BTP and how to integrate SAP ECC or S4 HANA which are on-premise to the cloud connector. But since cloud connector is an independent on-premise tool on an independent server, I don't have proper access to that. Hence, I will show you after the cloud connector has been connected, what are the things that we need to know and how we can see from a BTP perspective that a cloud connector is connected to my BTP and to which existing backend system or ERP system it is connected to. Thank you. Thanks a lot for watching the video. If you like this, please like and subscribe.